Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create project power loss design in Revit. As you can see on my screen here, I got my project reference before we start making our tutorial. Okay, so I think here is my preview. As you can see here, we got complex reset there and got our wood structure to create here also. So I think it's pretty much for introduction because I don't want to waste your time to preview about that. Okay, so now let's switch into our project together. And I just want to ask you, if you are first time here or visiting here to my channel, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for all notifications if you don't want to miss my future tutorial. Okay, now let's start to our project together. First thing, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new template first. Just Control and on my keyboard for shortcut key. Then I will go to Parametric architecture template, hit OK. So once I done that, Revit will transfer me to another Revit architecture template. Okay guys, here I am in Revit architecture template. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to our file there. First thing, I want to create our conceptual mask first. After that, only I log into my project, go to new and go to our family. And of course, I will start with English for metric and our conceptual mask. Then I just hit open up. Once I select that, I can hit open up. Okay, here I am in conceptual mask interface. First thing, I'm going to our level 1 here. The reason I come here because I need to create an accurate size for our project and give a dimension there. That's why I need to come here. RP for shortcut key for reference plan. Then I will pick here. And for here, I will be tied out for 5 meter for between our center line here. Just make it 5 meter. And I will make it 3 meter for vertical. So in total, it will be 10 meter by 6 meter. So now we done our first step. So second step, I need to go to my reference. Then I just press our point here. Just simply press here, 1, 2, 3. In total, will be 9. Hit escape a couple times. Then I'm going to connect all of them first. Just like all like this. Then go to our spline through point here in order to connect all of them. Then I'm going to spline through point again. Then I'm going to spline through point again. Okay, hit escape a couple of times. I think this guy we haven't connect yet. Yep. Now I'm going to offset our plan first. Select my center here and center here. Then I'm going to my property panel there. I just finding for offset, and offset there, of course you can assign for a new parameter also, but in the case I prefer to manually about that. So I will make this guy over there is 2.5 meter for offset from the ground. Okay, then I'm going to select another guy here, 1 and 2. Then I'm going to property again, go to offset. Then I will offset this guy over there about 5 meter. Hit apply. And of course for the center here, I need to offset also. One, I select that. Then I'm going to offset again. Just offset this one is higher than our previous one. Just make it 6.5. Then I go to my 3D there. As you can see here. Obviously, the point here you can assign for parameter, you just give a dimension there, but because it when you assign for a parameter on your offset, they are not running properly and not recommend to use that. In order to make a parameter for this kind of set, you might be need to create a set of a plan. Then you just give a dimension from here to here and from here to the ground. It's easier for you to control, but in my case there, as I told you before, I try to make it manually. So I'm going to select here 1 and 2 and 3. The reason I try to make it manually because I know what I want. So I'm going to create form and solid form. As you can see here, now I got my form already. It's time to load into our project. First thing, I'm going to separate this point there. I just go to file, then I'm going to save as first. go to family, then I just keep it on my desktop. I say this one is conceptual. Profile 1 like this. Then I'm going to load into my project here. Just load into my project 2. Then I'm going to place here 1. Hit escape a couple times. Once I select that, I'm going to copy that. Just simply copy that here. Just make it straight here. Make all of them is joined together like this. Hit escape a couple times. Don't worry about warning sign here. It's just a small issue. Then I'm going back to my 3D here for conceptual my interface. Then I just click all like this. Then I will divide surface. And of course, I will make it for, I think we just leave it 10 by 10. Then I'm going to save again in order to load again. Because if I directly load like this, here will be override same as my profile there. So here I'm going to save it for profile 1. Then underscore here, just make it for divide surface like this. So now after save that, my profile is a different profile, it's a two file different. So I just load again, just load into my project 2 here. Okay, as you can see here, now I can press here, hit escape, then I'm going to align it, AL for align, just align it like this, and align here as well, hit escape, go to my 3D here, my first one. Okay, sorry, here is my project reference. So here I can close first because I save already, and this guy over there I also can close actually. Let's close our concept first. Then I'm going to turn on for 3D here. Now what we need to do next, I'm going to our masking, then I'm going to our rules, just use our rules here. Then select here one by one in order to create that. Hit escape. Then this guy over there, let's see if we can change our pattern or not. Okay, we might be need to apply our pattern inside my concept environment. So I'm going to edit family first. Okay, so I'm going to our file there. I need to create another file here. Go to new, then go to family. In the case there, you can using adaptive component or using generate model pattern base or curtain panel. It depends on you. But I will using for metric generate model pattern base. Then I can hit open up. One, I want to make my size is accurate. What I'm going to do in order to adjust my panel there, I just go back to my 3D one here. Then I can select here first. Then I change my fit distance number to fit distance and change this guy from fit number to fit distance also. Then I can copy that just like here. Then I just copy, go back to my 3D pattern here. Then I can select here. I can adjustment here like this. Hit apply. Then go back to my 3D again because I need to know what exact dimension. Then I just copy here, Control C, go back again, select here again, then Control V, hit apply. Okay, as you can see here, so I'm going to our point, just like point anywhere can. But in order to create that, you need to apply for set a reference plane first, set for vertical. Then I will make it like this. Just make it for, I think we make it for 140 by 200, 100 by 100, I think. Then I'm going to move this guy over there is center. Yep. Select here and select again. Create solid form. Now I want to select all like this and assign a new material. Okay, so I'm going to create a new material here. Just make it for wood for our structure. Wood, go to our appearance library. Then I prefer using for bird semi glass. Hit apply and hit OK. Once I done that, I can load into my project here. Just load to my conceptual device first here, hit OK. Then from there, I can select my whole system there. Just change our pattern to family 3 here, we'll be changing it. Okay, as you can see here. So I'm going to load into my project to project 2 to for override graphic. So Revit will be asking him here, is it override the existing version or override existing version and it a parameter values? I prefer for number 2. Okay, as you can see here. Then here I can adjustment for, let me see first here, I can adjustment for material also. Just re-add new material and make it for rules like this. Then go to our appearance library. Just go to our color here, select here. Make it more thicker like this, hit OK. Apply, then hit OK. Then hit OK again. Apply, OK again. Then I'm going to change it all to realistic. Okay, as you can see here, we done our form already. Okay, it's quite smooth here. And of course here you can adjustment by make it to go down from your elevation here. Or you can make this guy over there is going up. Okay, we could not, so we might be need to use our arrow key in order to move it on. Yep, like this. Go to our 3D. Here is my 3D, I think. Okay, as you can see here, it's quite nice for our shape here. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much, but let me show you another tip first before I finish. If you want to export for image, you just go to your file there, because some of my subscribers, they requesting me how to export to image, so I will show him now. Go to export tab there, then you go to your image here, then just go to image, and for that you need to your output file here where you want to put at a cost for image size there, you just make it for 5000. The reason for that, because we want to make our photo or image is high resolution, because I know it's overkill if you make it 5000, but it's make your photo and image is high rise. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you for joining me from start to finish. If you like this tutorial, make sure thumbs up, like and subscribe. Thank you guys for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.